I have raised him up in righteousness, and I will direct all his ways. He shall build my city, and he shall let my captives, not for price nor reward, saith the Lord of hosts. Hi, my name's Ed. Ellerman is the last name. This is my office for the Son of Man Project at the present time. The Son of Man is a man chosen by God to lead the campaign to prepare for his return. And that's primarily what I'm doing. Labor Day in 99, the Heavenly Father gave me the thought process to put a mansion on Big Baldy Mountain for him to use when he comes back to reign and rule the new millennium. In studying the scripture after that, I discovered that there's the New Jerusalem and a whole lot of other things that go along with the project. Now, sitting around here, I have a lot of time to twiddle my thumbs and look at maps and whatnot. I was looking at a map of Israel, and I realized the letters USA are right smack in the middle of the word Jerusalem. And so I think that's kind of a unique similarity. I sometimes don't believe in the word coincidence. Things happen for a reason. Here close by where he wants the new Jerusalem, we have a mountaintop that somebody named Mizpah. Somebody named the highway pass up here, Cain's Hill. Did they know at that time that the Heavenly Father was going to want his mansion over on Big Baldy Mountain? I have no way of knowing. Then George Willett bought the ski resort and changed the name to Showdown. And of course, Showdown and Kings Hill makes me think of the Battle of Armageddon. And that's when the Heavenly Father executes the sword, and shortly thereafter he starts to rule, reign and rule the whole world. I was remembering that there was some scripture indicated that the New Jerusalem was going to descend from the heavens. All my life I was raised to believe that the New Jerusalem would be in Israel, just like most other people. I slipped off the edge of the road one night and hit the bridge up here by the cemetery. The truck come up over and it sailed over the guardrail and the sign on the opposite side of the highway. And it landed half on the highway and half off. It was just as though he picked me up and dropped me. Big old magnet. Several months later, I was looking at a map and I realized that the truck was actually pointing right straight towards Big Baldy Mountain. And I said, well, I guess that's how you drop the New Jerusalem out of the sky, huh? So I've never questioned it since. It was actually Labor Day in 99 when he asked me to put the mansion on Big Baldy Mountain. And I had no idea where I was at, so I went and bought a Forest Service map. On the mountain itself will be his primary place of domain. I have one picture that I talk about because it makes me think of an X. And there's an old phrase, X marks the spot. The New Jerusalem, my vision of it, will be convention centers that will pretty much be a complete little city within each building. You know, I have no idea how he plans on using it. My job is to try and get it done. Well, probably shortly after it's complete, the Battle of Armageddon will take place. From there, we will live on earth as it is in heaven, as Jesus gives us in the Lord's Prayer. You know, I was trying to read the Old Testament book of Ezekiel. I wasn't getting very far, so I laid the Bible on the dash and I looked up and I watched the little white lines come together until they created a face that I think was the Father making his face to shine upon me. There was a line just to the right hand of the Father that instantly made me think of Jesus at the right hand of the Father. Those two cloud formations slowly faded away and then a beautiful dove appeared. I don't know if you remember the Ferlin Husky song, Wings of a Dove, or not, but on the wings of a snow-white dove, he sends his pure, sweet love.
When these things be said of us, he doesn't forget us. He sends down his love,
sends down his love
on the wings of a dove,
wings of a dove
on the wings of a snow white dove. He sends his pure sweet love,
a sign from above.
Went through a divorce, lost a child to a crib death. For a lot of years, I wondered, where is God? And I really didn't care about life that much. I left Montana in 65, a teetotaler. I came back drinking a fifth a day, 7 days a week. Our first son, Ray, was born in January 1962. And my parents came up to visit us, and we went to Glacier National Park. And I got amorous, and she conceived. We named him Danny, and we were just fun-loving kids at the time. And I remember very well telling her, I said, well, God promises that he'll not give us more than we can handle. So life went on, and in the spring of 63, we woke up, and the little guy was turning blue. Crib death already had him. As important as it is, in my mind, it's still tough to talk about. Been a long time, and for all those years that I never cried, not knowing why, not understanding why. God had a plan, and he used that plan to instill in me the importance of asking for understanding instead of why. That was the prayer I left at the meadow. Why didn't I cry? Once God answered that, it was a great relief. And at the time those things were happening, I had no idea that today the crib death of that child that we had named Daniel has been such an important part of my spiritual development that even though I don't have a lot of fancy degrees, I've got a relationship with the Heavenly Father that few people know. Because I never planned on buying land again. Then I picked up a real estate flyer just to look at the picture. And this place was listed. So I jumped on the motorcycle that I had at that time and drove up here, and I shook my head and I said, oh God, you can't want me to buy that place. But he did, and I'm here. And it's been a ball being here, meeting people, sharing my testimony, learning from people. I'm a pretty firm believer that we each have a path that we've got to walk to get us to where God wants us to be. They're just, you know, these events in my life that I've been through, some of them sad, some of them happy, all of them work together to tell me, this is who you are. You know, I can't do what somebody else thinks I ought to do. I've got to do what God is telling me that I need to do. And that don't always make for a happy situation.
On the wings of a snow white dove,
He sends his pure, sweet love, a sign from above.